Today we will be performing the Benedict's test. This is a test for detecting reducing sugars. Reducing sugars are carbohydrates that are oxidized in the presence of an oxidizing agent. Reducing sugars donate electrons to molecules that accept electrons. Some reducing sugars include monosaccharides like glucose and fructose, and some disaccharides like lactose and maltose. Non-reducing sugars do not donate an electron to electron acceptors. Non-reducing sugars are disaccharides such as sucrose and polysaccharides like starches. Oxidation reduction or redox reactions occur when one molecule loses electrons, that's oxidation, and the other molecule accepts electrons, that's reduction. We will be using Benedict solution, which is an oxidizing agent that helps determine the presence or absence of reducing sugars. Here's the list of items we will use for our experiment. Test tubes, test tube rack, droppers, test solutions, Benedict solution, 100 degrees Celsius water bath, and hot mitts. Label your test tubes 1 through 8 and place in the test tube rack. Here is a table of solutions we will be using. 1 water, 2 starch, 3 sucrose, 4 glucose, 5 apple juice, 6 coconut water, 7 corn juice, 8 soy milk. Add about a half a dropper of each solution to the appropriate test tube. Now add 10 drops of Benedict solution to each test tube. Carefully place the entire test tube rack into the 100 degrees centigrade water bath for 3 minutes. Be careful, it's hot, so use hot mitts. After 3 minutes, pull the rack out of the water bath and set aside to cool for several minutes. Record your results. Clear blue indicates the absence of reducing sugars, or negative. Green-yellow with precipitate indicates trace to low levels of reducing sugars, plus orange-red with precipitate indicates moderate to high levels of reducing sugars, plus plus. Our results show that water, starch, sucrose, and soy milk give us negative results, whereas glucose, apple juice, coconut water, and corn juice give us positive results.